Hello everyone, Daft with you. In today's video, we'll take a look on how to handle RTOs or rejected takeoffs. I rarely see any videos about this particular procedure in the simulator, although it will be something interesting to know. For this RTO, we'll begin an engine fire. As you can see in the performance page on the MCDU or MCDU, the V speeds are as followed. V1 is 128, VR is 134, and V2 is 136. Your main eyes will focus on V1, because that's the speed is what determines if you can abort the takeoff or not. V1 is called a decision speed. You decide to abort or commit the flight. If you have an issue before V1, then by default we will reject the takeoff. Pull back on the thrust levers all the way to full reverses and brake. We want to stop as soon as possible because there's a list of things we need to do after we stop the aircraft safely. If you experience a problem after V1, then you'll handle as an in-flight emergency and so forth. So we are at Daytona, that's Delta Alpha Bravo, on runway 25 right. Everything is set and we're ready to go. Now we just advise everyone in the back that we're ready to go for takeoff. We're going to release the parking brake, advance the thrust levers to 50%. And we're going to use manual toga for this one. Clock the chrono, so man toga SRS. 18 center line. Around 100 knots, we're going to do a side stick check, make sure it's working. So that's 100 knots right there. That's been checked. Once you hear that alarming chime, as you can see right here, you're gonna pull back on thrust levers, full reverses, and then heavy braking, because you want to stop as soon as possible. Maintain center line as usual. And once the aircraft stops, we're gonna put the heavy parking brakes. Once we set the parking brakes, we'll advise ATC of our situation and declare an emergency. As an example, Daytona Tower, Daft Niner, stopping on runway. We have an engine fire, send fire brigade, standby. At this point, the runway is closed and it's ours for now for the duration. After we advise ATC of our issue, we'll inform on the PA to the cabin crew to be ready at their stations in the event that an evacuation is required. After we've done with the necessary calls, we'll initiate ECM actions, that's a read-and-do kind of thing. The first thing in an engine fire is to turn off the master switch for the engine that's affected, which is engine number 1. Unfortunately, it's not modeled in this ECAM, so maybe in the future they'll fix that. But we'll just assume that we did turn off engine master number 1. Next, we'll look up and overhead to look for the engine fire light that's on the left corner of the fire protection panel. We'll lift the red guard and push the engine 1 fire push button. If you're on the ground, there's no countdown, and we have to discharge both agents without any delay. Now if you're doing this in the air, there will be a 10 second countdown between each agent discharge. I'll demonstrate that in another video, mainly on how to handle engine fire in flight. At this point, when both agents have been discharged, this is where the decision to evacuate comes into play. If the engine fire light extinguishes, an evacuation is not necessary. As you can see here, the light extinguishes, so no evacuation is needed. Now let's do another engine fire with the other engine. We can release parking brakes. Let advance the thrust levers to 50%, and then we'll use manual toga. Or I'll use manual toga, you guys can use manflex or whatever. So manual toga SRS, maintain center line, 100, around 100 knots, we're going to do a flight side stick check to make sure it's working. That's 100 knots right there, it's checked. Once you hear the alarm, we're going to stop the aircraft, board the aircraft for taking off. So pull back thrust levers, full reverses, and heavy braking. Maintain center line as much as possible. Once you stop the aircraft safely, you're going to set the parking brakes. So parking brakes set. ECAM actions. ATC cabin crew will simulate that they just been notified. We'll simulate already that we turned off engine number 2. The master switch number 2 is off. Now if you look at the overhead for the fire protection panel, that's illuminating. So we're going to lift the red guard, push the push button, discharge both agents, and you'll see in a few seconds they'll extinguish. at this point there's no evacuation required. But let's assume hypothetically that after we discharge both agents, the fire still remains illuminating. As an example like this. But basically at this point you have to evacuate everyone without any delay. Now hopefully you found this very informative and helpful. If you do, then consider subscribing so you don't miss any other videos regarding Microsoft Flight Simulator and other aviation content. So thanks for watching, I'll be seeing you guys in the next video. Take care.